Welcome to Grow New Plants. So today I'm going to do some more fig cuttings, but these are going to be late summer fig cuttings. It's I think the 18th or 19th of July, and I've ordered some more fig cuttings off of, I think I got these off Facebook Marketplace from a guy down in Austin. And there's some varieties that I didn't have, a couple of varieties like an I-258 that I've been wanting to get. That's the Italian 258, I guess is what it's really called. And a couple other ones that I was kind of excited to get. So what I'm going to do is I'm doing a little bit different this time. My last ones I did, I got probably about 50% germination. And with these, I'm using a different soil. I'm using my bark mulch peat moss mix for these because I think the other ones just stayed a little too wet and a lot of them rotted before they ever came up. So I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to still use the same pots. I'm going to put them in I got them in the tray. I got the water tray underneath to help hold moisture from underneath where they can wick water up from the bottom. And so I'm going to get reset up and then we'll start sticking these cuttings. Is I'm going to come in here and I'm going to make a fresh cut on the bottom here. And I'll kind of go at a 45 degree angle, pretty close to a 45. So I got my 45 angle degree or 45 degree angle cut on that. And then this is my Clonex rooting gel. And I always just keep a little bit extra in a bottle here. And I'm not going to make an extra cut on these. I did on the other ones, but I've watched so much stuff on that, talking about that extra cut. And I really don't know that it's necessary, to be honest with you. Because of the majority of ones that I watch, the videos that I watch, they do not seem to root where you make that little scar cut across there. So I'm just going to give them this. Let them sit. Got the rooting hormone on the bottom. And then I am going to make a hole here, because this stuff's got some decent sized chunks in it, but I think it's gonna work out okay. So I'm gonna go pretty deep with it. I'll take this big one and put it in the middle and then kind of pack it in there. And we'll do the same thing. And these are all the Italian 158s or 258, sorry. We'll do all three of these like this. That one's already got a bud on top. We'll see what happens with that. We'll go with all three of these here next to each other. Put that in there. And then I've already got tags made up. You see my little nifty tags. I've got a video showing these. If you want to watch that, I'll put a link up at the top for that. So those are all three Italian 258s. And let's see, I've got one here that is a Moscatel Preto. And this is just one. This is one that the guy sent me as an extra one. He said it's one of his favorites. So I said, well, I'll give it a try and see what happens. So put a little bit of rooting hormone on that one. And we'll make a hole for it. We'll just go ahead and go right here with this one. I'm trying to get at least two nodes. You know, the bottom node and then the next node down. Try to get two nodes down below ground to give it a better chance of rooting. Okay, so I have my Foggit misting nozzle here. Oh, I just got my camera wet probably. So I'm just gonna mist these things in good. So that ought to be good for now, and I'll probably check these again tomorrow just to make sure that they stay moist. But if you look right here, see, I got this tray underneath that's going to catch water. That's probably a little too much. I'll dump a little bit of that out. So what will happen is these things will sit in here, and then they'll absorb that water from underneath and keep this soil moist. But as long as I don't keep that water level too high in there, they should be able to drain down and where they don't get overly wet and rot. So I'm going to move these things on the sides where they don't get in the way of my domes. And then I'm going to put the dome on, and I have the high 7-inch dome, and I'll put a link to that. These are obviously the Rootmaker trays. And I got links to a discount code too if you're interested in trying any of the Rootmaker stuff. I like starting these things in the Rootmakers because once they make roots, they can fill out and they'll go ahead and start root pruning and make a good full set of roots before I move them up into bigger containers. But I have that, and then this 7-inch dome fits perfect on top of this Rootmaker tray. So right there. So that'll give it, and I'm going to take this thing, I'm going to set it in the backyard, and I'll put it in full shade where it never gets any direct sun, but it'll get lots of natural light. So should do good. Anyway, I appreciate you watching. I will come back in probably 4 to 6 weeks when these things hopefully have some roots. Okay, so it has been right about 2 months now. It's a little bit longer than what I thought it was going to be. And I've got some success, not as much as I was hoping with these. I got 4 that have really rooted nicely. And I've got quite a few other ones. I pulled a few of these up the other day and looked, and they've got tiny roots starting to develop. And there's maybe 2 or 3 of them that I feel pretty confident are just dead, that didn't make it at all. So what I'm going to do, I don't want to, it's getting late in the year. It's mid-September now. So I want to get these up into 1-gallon pots so they can have a chance to get some roots built up going into winter. And then I'm just going to keep working with these other ones, and hopefully they'll get up and root early enough that I can still get them potted up. If not, I can move them inside. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and pull a few of these out. I don't know how thick the roots are on them, but I know they've put out a lot of growth, and they put out roots. Oh yeah, that's really nice actually. Completely filled out that pot, and this is a Ponte Tresa. So this is one of the ones that I was really hoping to get, so that's a good thing. So I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna just move these over here. And you can see, then I'm gonna go ahead and get these potted up. Pull that out for a second. So I'm putting these into my regular Rootmaker. I'm sorry, they're going into Rootmaker 1-gallon pots, but I'm using my 75% bark mulch, 25% peat moss with a Rootmaker 8 fertilizer in there. So, and if you're interested in that fertilizer in the Rootmaker pots and all that kind of stuff, of course I've got links to that in the description, and if you use my code, then they'll give you a 15% discount. So there is a Ponte Tresa, which I'm excited. That's a new variety that I didn't have before. I think I'm up to actual rooted plants. I'm up to probably about 10 or 11 varieties now. And I've got 11 more that I just bought off of FigBid that are gonna be showing up in a couple days. So hopefully I'll get those rooted before winter. So here is a LSU Gold. So I have LSU Purple already. I did not have LSU Gold. I have LSU Tigers in here, but I don't know whether those rooted or not. So that one's not quite as full as the other one, but it's still full enough to hold this soil together. So this is more than enough. They should take off and root off and survive just fine. Once they get to this point, I don't worry about them. Once they get to this point with that many roots, you start up potting them, take good care of them. You don't have much to worry about at that point. They're going to make it. Okay, so we got one LSU Gold and a Ponte Tresa that we know made it. And let's see what this one is here. This is another LSU Gold. So I did good on the LSU Gold. So far, the LSU Purples, which I have a bunch of, have grown great for me. Apparently these LSU Golds are going to grow pretty good too. The Tigers, I don't know whether I got those or not. We'll take a look at those other cuttings after I get these potted up. I may go ahead and pull a couple of them up just to let you look at them.
I know I pulled them up the other day and I had a few roots, but not much. But hopefully they'll survive and keep going. Now I have been hardening these off a little bit before I pulled these out. So these have been sitting outside, just outside in the shade for, I guess, really just for about a day. All right, so this is another, this is an I-258, which is one that I was really wanting to get. And that's got a super nice set of roots on it. Completely filled out that pot. That's the Italian 258, so that's one I was really hoping to get. And I did, so I'm excited about that. Get just a little bit more soil here. So I got four new varieties, and then hopefully I will still get some more after these. Like I said, these are golden now. These are gonna make it, gonna be just fine. Okay, so we got four good ones planted up, and then let's go ahead and we'll take a look at some of these. So this is another Italian 258. If you see on here, it's got some buds on it, but if I remember correctly, it's got a lot of callusing, so it's gonna make roots, I think. So I think this one will be fine. Whether it makes enough roots before winter or not, I don't know. This is another Italian 258. And you see it's got a little root on the bottom, and there's a couple more roots trying to pop out right there. So I think that one will end up surviving. So hopefully I'll get all three of these Italian 258s. I got another Ponte Teresa here, and this one I don't have much hope for. I think that one's pretty much dead, but I'm gonna go ahead and leave them in there for now. So that's LSU Tiger. I'm not seeing any signs of callusing or anything on that, so I don't think that one's going to make it. This is another LSU Tiger. And no signs of callusing or anything on that, so that's probably not going to make it. Another LSU Gold over here. Pretty much nothing on that. And this is two Ham Rams. Then this was a Muscatel Preto. That was one I was really kind of hoping to get, but it does not look very promising. I think that one's pretty much rotted, so probably not going to get that one. I only had one of those, and I got two of these Ham Rams, and they don't look very good up top. Well, but it's rooting. I just broke some of the roots off. That's that one that had that other branch on the side. We can get that back down in there. So I think I can leave that one, and then that one's going to probably end up rooting for me. And I don't know. I think it's trying to form a little bit of roots on it. So hopefully I can get at least one of these Ham Rams. LSU Tigers, I don't think I'm gonna get. So it looks like another Italian 258, maybe two of those, and maybe the Ham Rams. So it looks like maybe eight of these total out of the 13 that I'm probably going to end up getting something off of. But anyway, so I'm still working on this process. I've got a video I'm going to be putting out pretty soon. I did softwood cuttings in the misting bench, and those have come out really good. So I think I would say I've got almost 100% germination on the softwood cuttings that I did in the misting bench. So that's pretty exciting for me. That's a good way I can make all the cuttings I want to all summer long. You know, I'm going to hurt my fig production if I'm trimming everything off, but I can produce a lot of trees that way. So I'll probably save some trees for fig production and some just for cuttings until I can get as many of those up as I can. Anyway, I appreciate you watching. Please like, please share, please subscribe. Thank you.